Welcome back, blade lovers. I have a very interesting knife to share with you today. Sort of waffled on whether to get this back some time ago. Been looking at it since it came out. And this is the Wee Curvaceous. Yes. Quite a curvaceous knife is she, if you would allow me that expression. This is a design by Eric Ochs, and that's spelled O-C-H-S, and I'm pretty sure that's the pronunciation. He is a custom knife maker and designer from a company he calls Ochs Works. And I'm pretty sure he is also making knives as well as, you know, designing them. He's got his own selection of knives that are gorgeous, and one day perhaps I'll own one, but this is the closest I can come to getting something that he touched, in essence. I laid this out a little differently for you so that you can see some of the little things that come in the box, some of the stickers and what have you. Pretty typical for Wee. But also that, to show you that Wee of late, of 2022 or thereabouts, is no longer offering nice pouches like Kaiser does and Best Tech does. And I feel they're sort of economizing by using a hard foam cutout, which certainly keeps the knife safe. And there's the cover of the box. And if I might, if it doesn't take me too long, and it might. Oh, there it is. Just wanted to show you the sticker. Of course, that's upside down. That's what we've got here. Comes in a few different models. None of which is satin belt finished, which is what I really like, but I grabbed this one, and he really did come up with an interesting blade here, which is part Persian and part Tanto. Look at that. So we have a compound grind, hollow ground here, as we see on most of the Americanized Tantos, and flat ground at the front, except rather than a chisel type point, we have this upswept point. Very nicely appointed with really nice, I guess you'd call it kind of a faceted carbon fiber with large facets, pieces of fiber in there. Not sure what it's called. It's not marbled and it's not swirl, but it's its own thing. We've got an interesting clip that follows the contour of the handle. We have a nice swale towards the pommel there and a really nice finger groove with a guard at the front. It's a bolster lock, which essentially is a frame lock with most of the frame hidden underneath the handle scale. Some really interesting millwork here, these four hashes. Simply branded with Eric Ochs, the designer's name, and nothing on the other side. The Wee logo here. I don't see anywhere the steel, which is 20 CV, and it's a full-size knife. As you can see, got plenty left over on the pommel, and a long blade that is finally bead blasted to a kind of a powdery look. I don't know what to call that, but you're seeing that on more and more knives these days. Might show less marking, certainly less fingerprints. Can't get a fingerprint to really stick on there, which is nice, as you do on the satin blades. Going to jump into measurements. So overall, we have very close to 8 3/4 inches. We'll call it, 8.65. Got a blade. Lots of blade in that handle. 3 3/4 with a cutting edge of 3 3/4. So that was pretty simple. Blade stock in millimeters. 4 millimeters. Blade stock in inches. 0.15. Handle thickness in inches. 0.51. And weight. Drop shut knife, by the way. I have a weight of 5.3 ounces. 5.32. So a good size knife. Lots of blade in there in that handle. And yet we've still got a little handle left over. The backspacer is interesting in that it stands proud of the handle and is radiused or crowned. You can see that. Could have been flat, but they elected to sort of let it rise to the occasion. In fact, it's elegant, but it's fairly simple. There's not a lot of complex detail to it. It's just these swooping lines, and I believe that's why it was named Curvaceous. Lots of curves. Curve there, curve in here, curve at the top of the handle, and obviously a great big old curve, even long belly, and a nice swedge at the top. Now these edges are nicely smooth, but not crowned, and we do not have any jimping. Locks up on a pin, near as I can tell, there are not internal stop pins. It is on bearings, as you can see. Look at this. Just a little bit of effort. I haven't really broken this in at all. This hasn't been carried yet, but I will say the pocket clip works pretty well. You can see it's nicely ramped going in and going out. Pretty typical clip ramp. Not deep carry, and yes, not switchable. You can see the way the screws go there, not switchable to this side. Interesting that they went with a lanyard hole. Might have been good without one. But then if you tried to put a lanyard pin in the end, if you kept this form of the backspacer, you wouldn't really have that. Flipper tab, nice, with a little bit of jimping. Stands up ahead of the pivot, which makes it easy to deploy. Let's see if it can be failed. No, it swings out. Nicely tuned on the detent. Lock up, what is that? Really about 25%. Nice and tight, all directions. And is the blade centered? Oh yeah, spot on. Equal space on both sides of the blade, and it comes pretty close to the liners of the handle as well. Now when I saw this knife, it made me think of another. Tried to pick one that's as close as I could get to the shape of that blade, that Persian blade. And here is one from Kaiser, designed by Dirk Pinkerton, called the Nomad. I do not believe the Nomad is any longer in production. The Nomad has that long angled pommel and is slightly longer. It's all titanium, milled out. Still no jimping on the top of that guy either. and this one's an S35VN. So many of Kaiser's titanium handled knives are S35VN. It's just a staple. You hardly see anything else. Maybe in newer knives you do. If we were to compare size with the Griptilian, you'll see that this is definitely a larger knife than the Grippy. Either way that you stack it. Significantly, maybe an inch longer overall. And if we were to compare it to the Rat 1, whole different classification of knife and certainly price, because this guy's going for over $300. Not cheap. We knives have gone up a bit. We're almost dead on with the size of the Rat 1. Maybe it's just a tiny bit longer. And blade's just about the same. So another look around. Very simple, beautiful knife. Not very long in the back spacer, so you've got a lot of air in there. It is not weight relieved on the titanium scales or titanium liners. I really saw the blade and I really liked it. What can I tell you? Part Tanto, part Persian. Really neat clip. And most likely a keeper. Except for the Wii on that side, we have a very simple pivot surround there. Same color, same treatment as the bolster. So titanium bolsters and the carbon fiber handle. That is the Wii Curvaceous. Maybe not something you want to run out and get. It is a pricey knife. But as far as collectibles go, I think it's the first I have by Mr. Ochs, and I may be looking at some of his more custom-y knives from his company. Okay, don't forget to like this video and subscribe. There's a little subscribe button in the lower right about now. If you click that shield, my logo, it'll bring you to the subscribe page, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes up, or a short, or what have you. And don't forget to visit me on Instagram. I post a lot of Instagram images out there and videos. And that is old_sword on Instagram. There's a link in my bio. Take care.